Shields up, Ironbreakers. How's everybody doing? Today we're here to check out the Countess in Paragon. So this is obviously a new hero. Let's take a look at her. I've already seen her previously at the Epic HQ event, but she has changed quite a bit from what I remember. But then again, I didn't really play her back then because like she was very much unfinished, the animations and whatnot. Anyway, here she is. This is her Challenger skin, which to be honest looks really good. You guys know that I'm a sucker for like red and white for some strange reason, so this skin to me just looks badass. The character itself looks pretty friggin' badass. So this is the Countess. Now for those of you who don't know how these videos usually go, what we're gonna do is we are going to play a match against bots. First, I'm going to do a deck for her. I'm going to give you guys my opinions on what we should put on the deck for her. It's going to be my first impressions because this is one of the heroes that I've never played. Like her hair, like, woo! The hair just going crazy! But, let's take a look at her abilities to begin with, and then we'll see. Slice. Melee basic attack, dealing 30 physical damage. How does that compare to, say, Grux? Because I'm always, like, I always need to, like, compare 40. So she deals less damage than Grux. So what would we put her as? I think she's one of a kind. Because, like, she's not going to compare to any of the other melees. Because she's a melee caster. So, actually, before we do this, let's take a look at her stats. Yeah, there you go. So her basic attack is a 2. So, yeah, you're going to have to seriously think about how you're going to build this character, because you're not going to build her as you are used to on characters that look like this. You're not going to be building her with, I don't think you're going to be building her with attack speed. I highly doubt that. Instead, you're probably going to want to go for a cooldown reduction. Her durability is 1. I think that's the lowest of any character in Paragon to date. Like, even Gadget is a 2, 3, 9, 7, 1. No, Kalari's a 1 as well. So she's about as durable as Kalari. Which obviously means that this character is not my playstyle at all. Durability 2, 4, 7. Yeah, there's only one other character that's this low, and that is Kalari. Even fucking Chin Blast is a 2. So we're probably going to have to put some health on her. And then mobility is a 7. So I'm assuming we're going to have a lot of skills to move around and whatnot. So, once again, let's go back to her ability. Slice, 30 physical damage. Blade Siphon, right click. Countess quickly spins, causing 50 physical damage in a circle around her. Passive Countess regens a percentage of her maximum health every time she kills an enemy, 10 times more when killing a hero. Huh, so this is both an active skill and a passive skill. Interesting. Shadow Slip. Countess targets a nearby enemy and blinks to it, dealing 25 physical damage and applying a movement speed slow for 1.5 seconds. If the target is a minion, it is executed. Retrigger within 4 seconds to return to original position. It's to teleport, and then you can go back after you teleport. So you can go in, perform a skill, and bail out. Interesting. Dark Tide. Countess sends out a roiling cloud? I'm assuming rolling cloud? I don't think roiling is a word. Rolling cloud of darkness in front of her, dealing 80 physical damage to all enemies in the area of effect. This seems to be the highest damage thing. And then Feast. Countess jumps to a nearby enemy hero, forcing them to look at her and stunning them for 0.75 seconds before dealing 315 physical damage. Countess is locked down for the duration of the attack. So ideally, it looks like you're going to do Shadow Slip into someone, you're going to Feast, and then you're going to Shadow Slip out. Or maybe you Shadow Slip, depending on how fast you can do it. Maybe you Shadow Slip, Dark Tide, Blade Siphon, Feast, and then hop out. I think that's too many skills. That kind of sounds like too many skills, but you probably do want to do something along those lines. You want to combo more than one thing, so I'm assuming Dark Tide. I'm really feeling the Blade Siphon here for that early game survivability. And then Dark Cloud. Just have one on Shadow Slip, because it doesn't seem to do a lot of damage. So, yeah, I'm kind of really feeling the Blade Cypher in terms of damage there. But now that we know her abilities, let's take a look at how what kind of deck I would build for her. This is physical damage hero. What are her affinities? She has Growth and Corruption. Oh, that is an interesting mix. Growth and Corruption. Okay. Okay, so what do we have here? And why am I going through the Leap Gadgets deck? It's always what happens. I always delete Gadgets deck. Or do I not have a Gadget deck? Maybe I don't have a Gadget deck anymore. Maybe I just got rid of it. In which case, I think we're getting rid of her deck. Probably garbage anyway. I don't play her all that much. So let's get rid of her. Let's get a new deck in here. So for her, I'm going to want damage. So we're going to go Warlord straight up. This is going to be like full on glass cannon is what I'm predicting here. So starting things off, do we want 2 strike tokens and a potion? Is that a thing we want? Vampiric Elixir is not going to... I mean, Vampiric stuff's not going to work too well because she's going to be ability damage, not auto attacks. Which also kind of puts me off of doing strike tokens. I just don't know because, I mean, are we going to start by murdering people? Is that really the way we want to start this hero? Because this feels like more of a lane hero with ability power. Or maybe you can do jungle on it. I'm going to have to test out both methods. So I don't know what I'm going to do for the start, but I know what I want. I want at least one physical penetration card. So let's figure out what that one's going to be. No crit, because she's going to be ability power, so there's no use for crit. So we're definitely going to want at least one of these Void Steel daggers, chuck full of pierce. I'm thinking just actually like this. That'll give us a 9-point card. She does not have bleeds. Did they change Marrow Fangs? Wasn't this supposed to break shield targets? Whatever. Screw that. So now we have... Yeah, we don't want anything else for physical penetration. Actually, no. The Ward. The Ward can be our physical penetration card. I like that idea. Now let's take the Ward and go pierce, pierce, pierce. Hopefully we won't have to do more than this, but who knows? We're going to be going deep into damage, so now let's clear this up. We're not going to want attack speed. We're going to want cooldown reduction. Cooldown reduction. We got Chrono Spike, which we definitely want. Wow, there's not a single other interesting cooldown reduction card. We got Trigger's Touch. Lifesteal. Nope. Basic attacks. Nope. Lord's Ward. Actually, 3% of their current health. But it's a basic attack thing. Nope. We want the Chrono Spike. We want the Chrono Spike and we want a chuck full of deeps. Chuck full of that deeps. Let's actually go strike, strike, strike. So that gives us 2 9 cards. I might go 4 9s, 2 12s. We'll see. And after this, we just want damage. I mean, we don't have that much cooldown reduction, though. Are these really the only cooldown reduction cards? Feels weak sauce. Feels like I want more cooldown reduction for her. I might just take 2 Chrono Spikes. Strike, strike, strike. Might be too much, though. We also need to take some armor items. That's where we start having some, ooh. But again, it's basic attacks. Health regen, guard token, tune barrier. So do we want to go with the spiked bone plate Because if we go with the spiked bone plate, we're not going to have a lot of health. Fuck it. Spiked bone plate. Where's the other one? Thorn Greenweave. Actually, I don't like what I'm doing. This is getting a bit messy. Let's actually go for our regular Pierce until we get a better idea of what we're working with. Let's go Major Pierce. Is this even... I have Dire Pierce. I want Dire Pierce. Sorry about my indecision. It's just I've never played a hero like this before, and it's just weird for me. Now let's get rid of this. Major Guard. Greater Guard. Actually, no, fuck it. We're gonna put a Major Strike in here. We're gonna put a Major Strike in here, too. Wait, that's too much. Get rid of that. Okay, now we want is health. Let's take a look at health. Swift Queen Heart, Amulet of the Veteran. Heart of the Apex. Moves all debuffs, Butt of the Changeling. I think we're going to go Amulet of the Veteran, and we only have one of these, which sucks. I'll probably want Greater Health Strike Strike. This is the only health card we have? This is no good. I really don't like what we're working with here. We could go Drink the Spirits. With health. But I don't think it's going to be very good. Like Adamant's Edge, it is. I mean, at this point, we got two Chrono Spikes, we got the spiked bone plates. Yeah, but I don't think I want these. This is taking too much chances. Instead of that, we're gonna go with good old-fashioned Tempered Plate. We're gonna go Greater Health Guard Guard. We're gonna go Toon Barrier, Greater Health Barrier Barrier. Because we're gonna need additional health beyond what we're doing with Amulet of the Veteran. And after that, we're gonna wanna go Adamant's Edge. That's what I'm seeing here in this deck right now. Adamant's Edge. So let's take a gander here. So say we put the two Chrono Spikes, the Assassin's Ward, and the Amulet of the Veteran. That gives us four cards, one more for armor, and then one more for damage, and we're pretty much set, and everything else is just a build-up or alternatives. So we're going to get a Nad's Edge. And on this one, we're going to go Major Strike... Strike health. Kind of feel like I might be building her with too much health, but I don't know. I'm scared that I'm gonna die. So this is probably too much health. Once I get more comfortable with her, I might not want this much health. We'll see. Now at this point, we need to figure out what our starters are gonna be. And I gotta be honest, I'm really feeling Hunter's Drink. And two strike tokens. Hunter's Drink and two strike tokens. Oh shit, that's right. You guys just reminded me in chat, I need mana. For a hero like this, you're gonna need a fuck ton of mana. So actually, here's what we're gonna do. Here's what we're gonna do. Let's look at what we got for mana. Ring of the Domino gives mana. Drink the Spirits. Seriously considering Drink the Spirits. Fountain Spike, physical damage, and mana. Okay, actually, we're gonna even need mana at the start. That's the worst part, because she's a caster. I believe I forgot she's a fucking caster. So these Chrono Spikes can't be like this. I don't know how bad it's gonna be, but we're gonna put some mana in here. Probably gonna need some mana on a fountain. Seriously, fountain spikes, that's all? We're gonna need one of these at the start, and we're gonna want minor strike, strike mana. At least to get started. It also means I'll definitely want a mana potion. So let's clear the filter. Still only have one mana potion, despite all the decks that I've opened, still only have one mana potion. Let's go Hunter's Mana and Strike. No, I don't think we're going Strike. Because we're going to need an Escape, because our Teleport is offensive. We're going to need a Ward. Hunter's Mana and a Ward. Then we have the other Ward that's going to show up. We have two Chrono Spikes. This should give us some mana. I want to spam cast, so I'm going to go heavy on the mana too. And at this point, I might not want an Adamant Sedge. I mean, let's look at... We got 1, 2, 3, 4 cards. So we need one card for mana, one card for health. To remove that. Lord stuff is definitely... I think it might just have to be a Drink the Spirits. Which I'm gonna give two manas and a health. I think that's too much mana at this point, but we're gonna try it. We're gonna see how it goes. And the next thing we do is just full-on damage. It has to be full-on damage. It's gonna be an Amulet of the Veteran. They just strike, strike, strike. Boom. And that leaves us with enough space for one more starter card, which could be key. I'm going to go with a Brawler's. It's either a Brawler's or a Guardian's. No, a Lord's. A Lord's key. Right? Let me see all the keys we have access to. We got Executioners. We got Stalkers. Stalker's not too bad. Beastmaster. It's health, lifesteal. Brawlers, Guardians, Executioners, Lords. That's a weird combo, so we'll see how this works. Like, I'm not too keen on this deck right now. It's weird. It's a weird-ass deck. Maybe I'll start with a regular Chrono Spike and not go in with the mana one, because then at the end we're going to have the Drink the Spirits card. Okay. This looks alright. So let's take her out. Sean Silsby, does Lifesteal even work on skills? Because I don't think it does. We're going to take her Challenger skin because I like the Challenger skin so much. This is her default skin, but I just like this Challenger skin so much. That's what we're going to take. All right, guys, I'm receiving a couple of messages here. Okay, we got a tank, and they have a tank. Seems like they might have balanced out what you get with the bots. Can't wait until they have music in game. Really curious what they're gonna do with music. Okay, so Hunter's Drink, Mana Potion, Ward. Like I said, we're gonna start with Blade Siphon. 1% max health per unit killed. Actually not as good as I thought. I kinda wanna just take Dark Tide instead. Let's take this for now, it's passive. And it's 10% if you kill a hero, so. Not sure I should be doing mid lane though. Who do we have on our team? We have a Fae, so technically speaking, I could do left lane. Seems like the ideal character to do left lane on, actually. I might just farm jungle. Let's check out her viability as a jungler. Let's see if I was right or wrong. Oh god, she's so slow. Yeah, she is way too slow for jungle clear. Yep, not gonna be a viable jungler at all. What the fuck's happening in this mid lane? Shit! Gotcha, squishy. Just really squishy. She's gonna have to be in lane, like. Oh god. Like on a player match, I'd be dead like 10 times over. That was a waste. There's nobody on the right lane. I'm not gonna be able to do much, I need to go back. He is a very surgical character.
Allied tower is under attack.
Okay, let's actually go to the left lane and see if I can hang out there. I definitely get a vibe that she just needs to be a solo laner. Yeah, Zach, I know you're telling me to treat her like Kalari, but if I was playing Kalari, I'd be going through the jungle and ganking the lanes, and that's not what you're going to be doing with this character, because, like, you've just seen her jungling right there, and doesn't seem very viable on first impressions. It's too slow because of her weak-ass auto-attacks.
An enemy has been slain.
Her auto attacks are slow. I mean, even for last year, her auto attacks were way too slow. It's a good thing you guys reminded me about the mana. That was going to be a serious fucking problem. So I actually want the Dark Tide to max out. Still low on mana. Myself killed right there. Yeah, I definitely don't want to be trading blows with people. Yeah, I'm definitely gonna need more damage and just more mana in general in this deck, and maybe even less life. Like, fuck the tanking. She needs to be more of a glass cannon. This character is like, is gonna be one of those characters that I'm not gonna be playing a whole lot of, I can already tell. Okay, so, let's start with a Fountain Spike. Hopefully that helps us a little bit.
An allied tower is under attack.
Guys, you can't say this hero sucks, particularly when someone like me is playing it, because, like, if I was playing a hero like a tanky hero, a melee hero, or a caster, you know, like a typical caster hero, then you could judge the performance. Like, I'm playing a hero that's like fucking Kalari, and I suck at Kalari, so you can't say this hero sucks from watching me play. At least until I get the hang of her. Last hitting so hard.
Enemy has been slain.
Okay. Tell me how much she sucks now. Biggest problem with her right now, for me at least, is last hitting. It's the biggest thing. I could have made an even bigger burst if I had used my E after the R, which can be done. Just don't know if I have enough mana because I kind of want to do it. Their spell casting feels great though. I need more mana. I need a lot more mana. Thinking about making whatchamacallit. Okay, what the fuck is Rampage doing in there? Crazy bastard. I'm thinking about making Drink the Spirits my second card. Maybe make that a lower cost point? Go back, we got 6 points. The problem is you can't really go Spirits first card because you need the mana. So we actually need Chrono Spike with mana. Not the mana, you need the damage is what I'm saying. So I can't just go Drink the Spirits second card, even though I really want to, because you need more damage. Otherwise your damage is going to drop off. And you can't look at bots as an example because bots are going to suck, doesn't matter what. Okay, let's see the burst potential on the combo. I need line of sight. It's pretty good. Are you running away, Twin Blast? I shouldn't have gone back. I should have stayed on top of her. Yeah, this is gonna take a serious time getting used to. Teleport to a minion to get out of that. Aw, shit, killed by a bot. Yep, I know. It happens when you're testing stuff out, dude. I was testing how tanky it was gonna be. It's just not enough. Roll not only it silences. No, it stuns. In silence, it stuns. 0.75 seconds. Crap, that left lane's looking terrible. I've been roaming too much and not laning enough. Like, our farm is atrocious. That's a serious problem. And I think that's going to be my main problem with this character, is going to be the farm. Fucking bot Decker's about to kill me over here. Jesus Christ. too little damage. That last hitting on her is just the worst thing ever. Like, I don't think I've had this much trouble last hitting with any other hero. So we're able to go in, do two skills, get out, and I'm gonna get wrecked by this friggin' minion wave. And we're out of mana again, time to get out. Okay, we can get strikes now, but we need more mana again. So I'm gonna go drink the spirits next. I only have 2 points though. So I'm gonna get rid of the ward, and I'm gonna get the real ward. This is terrible performance for a bot match. I got a 16 minute mark, 2-1-2, and 30 minions.
Enemy tower destroyed.
I need to figure out a way that I can just keep her mana flowing at all times. Five last hits. Ugh. Disgusting. Tower. Should be able to steal their blue if they haven't gotten it. Needs more cooldown. Way more cooldown reduction. Talking like, fuck drink the spirits, I'm actually going to get a Lord's Pendulum.
An enemy has been executed.
God damn it, bots are so dumb. Quite enough out of you, gaming. Like, she needs blue at all times. Like, this character doesn't even work without blue. Where the fuck did he go? Oh. There you are. Her basic attacks are so low. You'd almost figure that she should be regenning mana instead of health. If she could get mana from kills instead of health, it'd be 100 times more useful.
Enemy inhibitor is under siege.
We need more damage. But we also need mana, that's the problem. We're constantly running out of mana. This character should only really be played by advanced players, which I'm gonna be honest, I'm not even up to the task of playing this character right now. Where do you think you're going, Fenmal?
Killing spree. An enemy has been executed.
I need to get used to her E being her main burst. Once you start getting a couple of kills, she definitely starts feeling better. Problem is, she has. I think she feels like the weakest early game I've ever seen in a Paragon character. This is one of those characters, like, if you're just starting out on Paragon, this character's not for you. The worst part is that it looks so cool, there's gonna be a ton of new players that are gonna be like, oh fuck, I wanna play the vampire dude. Vampire chick. And then they're gonna, like, die repeatedly. They're gonna be like, man, this fucking game sucks. I was trying to ult on the Fenmal, and I couldn't. Destroyed. We ran out of mana again, didn't we? Well, we kind of ran out of health too, so Drink the Spirits does seem to be an extremely useful card. The very first burning. So at this point, I'd get rid of that, and I'd either get that or that. I'm probably gonna get rid of Lord's Key because I don't like it. Because I'm never gonna be doing friggin' whatever harvesters with this character. So if I'm playing against players at this point, I'm probably getting a plate. So let's say I'd get this. Let's see how this feels. Here's the problem though. I mean, at this point we have like no damage. You look at my cards. There's no damage in there. So I can't do that. At this point, I have to put more damage in before I go for the armor. Oh shit, did they get an inhibitor? Oh my god. Fucking bots, dude. And I wasn't even looking, I was just like too busy figuring out the character. I'm gonna lose a fucking bot match. That's what's going on right now. There is no way that I'm pushing back super minions. of damage. I can just execute the superhuman. That works.
Enemy inhibitor is under siege. An enemy inhibitor is down.
I think they need to switch the affinities on her. We need blue cards in here that give you mana. Damage. So I panicked and I queued out. I should have kept the onslaught. Also, her ultimate does not take as much mana to perform as you'd expect. Need to balance out the scopes on this side of the map. I love the fact that I can just take out the super minions though. The more skilled players, that's actually going to be really cool for minion wave pushing, because you can just take out the siege minion in the back and like you can build fat stacks of waves that way. This fucking power already, please. Okay, so next up we need damage. So that's another Chrono Spike right there. I can't get rid of the mana potion. There's no way you can get rid of a mana potion, right? Yeah, fuck that noise. Okay, so I still need to get rid of this stupid left lane, otherwise it's gonna win the game because my bots are just like not paying attention to it. You have mana problems? Yes, put more CDR, lol. It still needs CDR, dude, it doesn't matter. It needs more mana and more CDR. That's what this deck needs. And I'm actually not sure. Does armor penetration work? Yeah, it does work. Look at the fatty wave they build up here. Look at the stacks of health we're getting. Hey, Greystone, welcome. Why don't you stay in this lane? No? Fucker. Gonna let my wave build up. See, the wave of stat is stacking, that's why I'm waiting. We go back. Hey man, how many monitors do you have? 3. So now that we have that, have how many points? 6? Finish that. Give me some Pierce. Now let's try killing some people, because now we're going to have the advantage in every lane, so I can do whatever I want.
An allied tower is under attack. Allied tower destroyed.
Definitely drink the spirits. Most definitely drink the spirits. I wouldn't mind having red buff too.
The enemy core is under attack. The enemy core is almost finished.
Okay. Oh shit. I'm sorry guys, I forgot. Forgot that the camera was supposed to be on the left. Completely forgot about that. And again, it's a bot match, I don't think it's too important. Okay. Let's take another look at this deck of ours. I don't like it. I don't like it one bit. We gotta figure it out. We have to figure it out. So, let's take a look at her. So we definitely want the Assassin's Ward still, though. Blunt Pierce. So we can leave that in there. Our start is weak. Real weak. So I want a strike token in there. Like, she needs all the help she can get. Now, beyond that, I'm going to need... Wait, I have more than one Fountain Spike. I thought I only had one. Why did I thought I only had one of these? Either way, mind a strike, strike mana. And I might even want another one of those. I'm thinking, do I want another one of those, or do I want a cooldown reduction one? We do have mana regen cards as well. Clear Heart increases all healing received by 1%. So every kill that I do. And it gives me mana regen. What would I replace it with? I would have to replace this with Drink the Spirits. And it gives me mana regen instead of mana. So no, we're not going to do Clear Heart. Overflowing Gifts is interesting. I don't like these regen cards, though. It's like, when it's time to regen, it's time to fucking go back. Circle of Mana, though. It's too supporty. Most mana regen cards start at 0.3. So Circlet of Mana starts at 0.9. It's almost like having a Gift of the Rains chuck full of basic sparks. Not quite. It's close, but not quite. And it gives you health, though. It's regen business. I don't like it. I like Gift of the Rains, though. That's what we want. Drink the Spirits, whatever this thing. Drink the Spirits. This is definitely going to go health, mana, mana. But we're not going to be able to complete this card. We're going to put it up there. We're not going to complete it. We're going to leave completing it towards the end of the match. What the fuck did I do there? Minor mana. Basic mana. These are the three cards I'm pretty sure I want. Now, give us the cooldown reduction. See, here's the thing. I can have a Pendulum of the Lords at the start, or I can have another Fountain Spike. And I think we need another Fountain Spike for additional damage, for making that last hit a little bit easier. So we're gonna do Chrono Spike with mana? Strike? Minor Strike? I got confused there for a second. Oh, Major Strike, Strike, Mana. And we're going to want even more of it, so we definitely want another one. Major Strike, Strike, Mana. So the problem with this is that it's too much mana. We got two Chrono Spikes. That takes us to 10% cooldown reduction, right? Yes. 10% cooldown reduction. Still need more. Trader's Touch. Basic attacks deal 3% on players. 3%. Their current health is additional physical damage. No, it's pretty weak. It's too weak. It's too weak. There's no damage on cooldown reduction, so two Chrono Spikes is all I can afford. Two Chrono Spikes is all I can put in the budget. still feels like you should have a pendulum of lore. She's just, you're basically going to have to farm blue when you're playing this character. You don't have any other chance. So at this point, we just need flat damage. Flat damage, because we got enough, we should have enough mana to sustain. And these three cards are going to be up every match. So after that, we definitely want the Tempered Plate with the greater health. Isn't there a 3-point green health? Yeah, beta guard. No, there's a guard. Okay, we'll take greater health, beta guard, minor guard. Twin barrier. Beta barrier, greater health, minor barrier. Takes care of our armor needs. So again, our final deck would be Assassin's Ward, Chronospike, and this. This gives us 4 cards. We got 2 more cards, damage. 2 cards that have to include damage. This is where shit gets tricky. I kind of like the charging boot. We could gain a lot of attack speed with this card. Scourging Tales is pretty cool too. I like Scourging Tail. I think we'll take Scourging Tails and Charging Brute. Now here's the problem. That was counting 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm not counting with the armor. That makes 5, and that makes me having to choose. Doesn't mean I like Scourging Tales any less, mind you. It does mean we're gonna lack health if we make that choice. We're just gonna have the health from Drink to Spirits, and that's it. It's about 300 health, plus 1 from the armor. Now we're gonna have to make a choice between Charging Brute or Scourging Tales. Which I guess you could make the choice like, are we winning? Take Scourging Tales. Are we losing? Take Charging Brute so that you can constantly run away from people. I just like the Charging Brute card. Maybe we don't need armor if we play our cards right. I don't know. But I like this idea. I like this. I'm gonna keep the armor, but I would say on the base deck, let's just not build armor, which is insane. It's insane to say in the current meta, let's not have armor. It's like anyone catches me out of position, blammo, instantly dead. Gonna do one more bot match, and then what I'm gonna do for you guys is I'm actually gonna stop the stream. I'm gonna try to get a good match in, and I'm gonna record it. I'm gonna upload a later video because you guys know that when we get to, to actual matches, what's gonna happen is I'm not gonna be able to guarantee that I can pick the Countess. So Noah Mendenhall, why not Thorn and Spiked? Because she has very little health. Too little. Wrists are killing me. Two tanks on the opposing team. No ranger. There's the ranger. I think it's risky as hell not to have a ward on your first lane. But I'm gonna have to play with that. I don't have a choice. You need more damage for the last hits. You definitely want her on blue lane.
Prepare yourself.
Then on first back, you get your ward. So now that I know better how she works, we're going to start with Dark Tide. Dark Tide is the way to go. Seriously, that all the bots come left with me? It's gonna be a clusterfuck to try and last hit. Early game damage is actually quite impressive. I need to get rid of the Hunter's Drink because my main problem is going to be survivability early game, not late game. Actually, it's going to be survivability the whole game. At least we have three, we can go back. Hopefully someone takes that right lane. It's like Greystone's had it over there. Okay, gonna get Assassin's Ward now. It's gonna give us damage and warding abilities. I might consider a Brawler's Ward though. No, because then we wouldn't have the penetration. No wards at the harvesters at the 4 minute mark. Feels bad, man. Sucks to be laning with somebody else on this character because it's like you're not getting last hits, so you can't stay in lane as often as long as you want. Shit, I thought I had to fall down. thought I had fell down the ledge and I didn't. God, she's squishy. It's gonna take me a lot of matches to get a good match. Farm is atrocious again. Odd matches fucking suck for practice. Fucked up. Fucked up so bad. Rampage? What the fuck happened there? Her E wrecks, though. Her E is like a wrecking ball machine. Bruno, remember, this is a bot match. It's not particularly easy to break things down. Not particularly hard to break enemies down.
An allied tower is under attack.
I'd like to take their blue. If I can get away with that. So bad. Can barely solo blue for crying out loud. Why the fuck am I trading blows with Richter? Am I retarded? You can't trade blows with Richter. You'll win. Spoiler warning. Okay, let's grab... Did I only bring one Fountain Spike? Alrighty. In that case, I want to test something. Really? Wait, actually, we can do more than this. We can make it better. We can do this and this. We can make it better! We can build it bigger! We can make it better! Why charging Brute? Because it gives you movement speed based on things you kill. So if you're in a lane constantly killing stuff, you're going to be moving pretty fucking fast. Now in a bot match, I'm not sure how this is going to work out in my favor, because like I'm constantly swapping lanes because it's a bot match. But, like, if you're constantly in your lane, I think this is going to work out great. We'll see. Yeah, like, look at this. Oh, come at me, Rampage. Fucking come at me, bro. You think you're badass? You think you're some tough shit? I'm dead. Maybe not. Woo. Hey, Murdoch, don't laser me, bro. That didn't go over as well as I'd like. God damn it. An allied tower is under attack. Fucking Rampage. Suck a dick. Feels bad, man. Shouldn't have done that. Died twice in a bot match. They should just delete my game for me. They just get banned. It's like, you died twice in a bot match? Fuck you. Get banned from the game. Forever. Huracan, do you prefer melee or ranged casters? Ranged. Casters should be ranged. The reason they're called casters is because they cast spells. I suck at this character. Like, where the fuck is he shooting me from?
Your skill rises.
Did you actually miss Murdoch? What happened there? You're seriously losing to towers against bots. Oh God. What have I done? I dived headfirst into a fucking turret's nest. Good job. What the fuck is this Grux doing? My bots are just like terrible.
Allied tower is under attack.
I'm gonna have to break an inhibitor if I wanna keep practicing. Sure that Twin Blast can handle it. You take care of mid lane next. No way in hell I'm gonna kill that friggin' black buff. Oh my God, Twin Blast, what the fuck? Keep having to be pushed back. Okay, so next we need more damage. Gonna get rid of this. Gonna get us one of these. That also gives us the cooldown reduction. We got 2 points left. Thinking about the Scourging Tails. But I also need more mana for the Chrono Spike. Or we can just get mana here. We need to start filling up.
An allied tower is under attack. An allied tower is under attack.
Dang, meow. You're dead. It's over. Richter over there needs to be persuaded to get the fuck out. Beginning to get the hang of her. Still need blue though. See how much faster we're moving because of that? Isn't this shit insane?
Massacre.
God, this is a good card. It's perfect for... Did it target me? Your inhibitor died, dude. You upset? That can make your day a lot worse. Run, you bitch. My plan is to have the minions kill him. It's working.
Unreal.
Dumbass bot. Oh my god. That's so good. Shit. No. I'm gonna have the minions kill you too.
An enemy has been slain.
Watch. My prick. Ulti me, I didn't even see what happened there. I was so greedy right there, though. Health, mana, finish this up. I need to get rid of a health potion. And I need, what, Scourging Tails or Chrono Spike? I think I need another Chrono Spike. Leave Scourging Tails for last. Then get more penetration because of all the armor in the meta. Riveting gameplay from the what's his face here? Four times in a bot match. Should be an achievement for that. Maybe when you get to five, the achievement pops up. You've died five times in a friggin' bot match. Good job. So I can see the appeal in the character. She's clearly not for me, but she's gonna be a lot of fun for players who like Kalari. They're gonna love this character. that's another death. When do I get my achievement? Okay, so at this point, I would want the Scourging Tales. Are you on full concentration mode? No, dude, I'm just trying to figure out my playstyle for this character. Yeah, my main problem right now is that she doesn't have enough survivability in this deck for my personal playstyle, which is a personal problem of mine, which is I play characters too aggressively. And I'm not a particularly patient person. So this hero in my hands is going to be very hard for me to adapt. Reach 100 deaths in a bot match and then I get the trophy? Okay, I'll get right on that. God, these bots are useless. Look at this right lane. Yeah, I'm not going to be able to evolve my knowledge of her anymore until I actually start playing her on player matches. Why would I actually want to trade blows with Fang Mao? I'm never going to be able to 1v1 a Fang Mao. It's impossible. Like, look at this. And he's 3 levels lower than me. Maybe I can do something else, though. Try this. Stop running, you bitch! And then he turned around all of a sudden. What the fuck? An allied tower is under attack. What the hell are you thinking? Goddamn bot. My first impressions, she's going to be amazing for players that like this playstyle. It is not my playstyle at all. So I'm now going to take the stream offline. I'm going to play a couple of matches, see if I can find a good match that I commentate. And I'm going to post a video on it so that you guys can get some actual PvP footage. But again, she is not my playstyle. So doing a video like that is going to be a pain. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the live stream. If you did, make sure to hit that like button. If you're new, remember to subscribe so that you're notified whenever I go live. Thank you guys very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.